parking lot.
The present era, corporate social responsibility is gaining prominence. As future managers, it becomes imperative for us to inculcate the ideals of giving back to the society. Today, we are honored to have among us Professor Mohammad Masood Ahmed, Dr. Singh, and Dr. Sudhir Sharma. Professor Mohammad Masood Ahmed is a professor of healthcare management with five postgraduate degrees, MBA, MCom, MA Economics, MSc, and MPhil. He is currently serving as a group director, Vidya Group, Andhra Pradesh. He served as the past president of AIIMS, past president of MDSA. He is well known for using poetry in his conversations. Some global recognized institutes that he has visited are Harvard, Stanford, Wharton, Kellogg's, John Hopkins, and London School of Economics. We are very pleased to have you here, sir. I would request Professor Kapil sir to present a bouquet to our chief guest, Professor. Now I request Professor Pathak sir, Dean Student Affairs, to present a bouquet to the chief guest. We are very pleased to have you here, sir. And now I'll welcome Swami Jyoti from the Samaritans team so that he can tell us about how MDI is based contributing to the social aspect of the society and how going forward it can contribute to make a more powerful impact. I'll welcome Swami Jyoti and his team to come on the stage and present.
Pipeline of this NGO for the upliftment of women
We have associations with Chetna and People for Parity. We've conducted several talks and sessions with them. We the People, it's an NGO which aims to expand an active, engaged and informed citizenry in India. In association with them, we have conducted workshops. Ashish Center, it is an initiative which works for the upliftment of people with disabilities. In association with them also, we have several projects in pipeline. Youth for Seva, it is basically a platform where the youth can connect with several social initiatives which are carried on. In association with Youth for Seva, we have come up with an initiative called Read Out Loud, which we shall discuss in subsequent slides. National Thalassemia Welfare Society, in association with the society, we have conducted several successful blood donation camps and we have also been recognized for the same. Tetra Pak, our students have worked with Tetra Pak to launch an initiative called Dobin, which we will discuss in subsequent slides.
Coming to our events and activities part, first of all, blood donation camps. MDI, in association with National Thalassemia Welfare Society, conducts blood donation camp every year twice. So last year we were able to collect around 208 units of blood, and for this we have been doing this for the past several years, and recently we were recognized on a thalassemia convention that was held in AIIMS for our work on this aspect. Students, professors, staff members, everyone, all of the entire MDI community comes forward and participates in this event. Next, Prayatna School of Excellence is an NGO with which we have very regular interaction and strong association. Prayatna is an NGO that has School of Excellence centers in various parts of the city, and their major purpose is to provide education to students going to government schools, as well as because it has been noticed that teaching in the government schools has not been up to par as well, and therefore they are coming up with these centers which can help these students have mastered some of the subjects. What do we do in them? Our regular activities include going to visit these centers on Saturdays and Sundays, and we take regular classes depending on the schedule and depending on the curriculum that are followed in their schools. Apart from that, we also try and inculcate a sense of overall personality development in the students by engaging them in various extracurricular activities, and we try and help them groom their overall personality. Next, collection drives. All around the year, we have various collection drives within MDI as well as outside the college. First collection drive that we went was with Youth for Seva. It was a collection drive that happened in an RBI colony in East Delhi. The major purpose of the collection drive was to raise funds for people who were affected by the Uttaranchal floods at that time. So our efforts were used for helping the school students, for helping the rehabilitation of the school students by giving them school kits. So entire package of a bag was provided with all the regular facilities that are required for a student who is visiting a school. Apart from this, we have regular books, newspapers, clothes, as well as blanket collection drives within MDI. Clothes and books and newspapers are used and donated to Rhythm of Life NGO, who use them to create a variety of paper products, and apart from that, we also use them for funding our regular club activities. Clothes and blankets are mostly focused on during the winter season, where we are able to provide these clothes that are donated by the entire MDI community to various people who are living inside MDI, like mess workers, laborers, as well as people who are living on the streets. Next, events throughout the year. The Joy of Giving Week is an event that is conducted once a year, wherein the entire MDI community comes up and donates money for various NGOs. Last year we were able to collect around 32,000, and the entire money was donated to the NGO Medhavi Foundation, which provides career counseling to students going in government schools. Apart from that, we have a Beyond Karma, which is the flagship event of Samaritans in Imperium. Imperium is the is the annual fest of MDI, and in this we invite students from across all these schools to come and participate in a case study competition. We have various corporate associations also in this event, like we had Coca-Cola, PSN Education and NDTV who partnered with us, And the major objective in these case study competitions is to harness the management acumen of students who can come up and deliver real life solutions to problems that are facing society. Next, Akshar. It is a cultural event, cultural and sports event that is conducted by Samaritans, that is centered by Sanskriti and Sportscom. And in this event, we were able to bring kids from Prayatna and organize dance competitions, cricket competitions for them. Next, Aroham. This is the flagship event of Samaritans and Sanskriti. This is a 4-day event that is conducted by Samaritans and Sanskriti team together. The event started off with a blood donation camp, and we were able to raise 72 units of blood this year. Next, we had a Nazaria case study competition, where in association with the NGO Score Foundation. Score Foundation is founded by Mr. George Abraham. He was the judge of that case study competition. The major purpose of the case study competition was how we can involve or help in employing visually impaired people in the corporate sector. When Mr. George Abraham visited our campus, he said that for visually impaired people, it is very difficult to have proper support that are required in a particular campus. And hence he was talking about a concept called universal design, wherein all our buildings, all our networks of ATMs, banks are designed in such a manner that it does not differentiate between a normal person and a person who is visually impaired or facing any other disability. So we came up with a universal design activity with the help of which we tried to help the students understand what are the challenges and difficulties that a visually impaired person might face when he is operating in the regular operations of MDA. So what we did, we blindfolded Mandavians and then we asked them to find out particular classrooms, do specific tasks that normal students are able to do, and then share their experience on how we can improve the infrastructure of MDI to better facilitate these people. Next, we had a Mandavian Miles. It was a mini marathon around MDI where students from MDI as well as people outside came in and participated. It was followed by various workshops and interactions that were conducted with various NGO owners or NGO founders who come in and share their experiences, involve the people, encourage the people to get involved in various social welfare activities, as well as motivate others to take up social causes. And we had a day with the Prayatna kids and also Anavidya, the Nukkad Natak. It was conducted by Sanskriti and it was based on the inhibitions that people face while donating blood. We the People is an NGO that works towards involving, helping the students, helping the people understand their rights and duties as citizens of India. So they conduct a workshop called Citizens Cafe every year, and the purpose of this workshop is to help the students understand their fundamental rights, their fundamental duties, and how, and also make them aware of the channels that are existing in the system, how to use the RTI Act. Suppose a street light is not working in your colony, what are the appropriate channels to contact which will help you take initiative on that? So this NGO comes to our campus and helps the students understand their rights and responsibilities as a citizen of India. Finally, we have various awareness campaigns that are conducted throughout the year, like Save Water campaign, Save Electricity campaign, AIDS awareness campaigns. And we also these events are conducted both online as well as around the campus with the help of various videos, theme plays, and we'd like to show you a small video on conserve water that we presented last year.
Thank you. now I would like to take you through the various life projects which are being floated by Samaritans in association with the various organizations. So first of all, we have Dobin, which is an ecological life project, where the main issue here was that there is improper segregation of the dry waste and the wet waste. So what happens is when they are mixed together and then taken to the landfill, it actually releases toxins which are harmful for the ground, and they also cause health hazards which are harmful for the waste segregators who are working over there. Now, it's two types of waste. One, the dry waste, which comes from regular household activities like, you know, general objects, paper, plastic. They are segregated into the dry waste category. And the wet waste category includes kitchen items like cooked food or maybe, you know, flour waste, etc. Now the problem here is that there is lack of awareness about this segregation and the problems that are caused if waste is not segregated accordingly. And also, even if people are aware, then there is an unavailability of proper waste bins so that we can segregate the waste. So now, in this initiative, this was actually an initiative by Tetra Pak and Coca-Cola, where Hindustan Times was a major media sponsor. What happened here was that students from MDI, along with various other volunteers, they went majorly to DLF Phase 4 area, where they conducted sessions with the maids and servants of the residents in that area to make them aware of this issue. They also conducted talks, debates, and painting competitions at the school level, so that, you know, at a very young age, people are aware of what this issue is and what are its disadvantages. And finally, there were workshops conducted where people were actually shown the advantages of recycling. For example, they were actually shown about how 5 PET bottles can actually make a shirt. So if you segregate waste accordingly, it can help in recycling even more. The students of MDI, along with other volunteers, as I mentioned, helped in promotion of this initiative, where they went to different households to talk about this issue. An operational partner of this issue, IPCA, they are actually making a dry waste collection and sorting center, which is going to be made just near the Kandarpur metro station in Gurgaon itself. And even they were involved in promoting the issue. And since this project was taken at a very grand scale, the result was very good, because we could actually see people using the twin bin system in and around MDI and also in the DLF4 phase area. And the great impact of this was that, first of all, the health hazards would be reduced if this is followed in a long term. And also the income of the per capita income of the ragpickers will be improved with this. Next, we have the EduDisha project. So this was in association with Medhavi Foundation. Now, Medhavi Foundation follows a self-sustaining model which is divided into two parts. One is called the I Dream Career, where they provide career counseling services to the affluent people, and it's a normal business model, and they generate revenue from this. So now they use that revenue generated in this project, which is called the EduDisha project, where they provide these same services to the underprivileged children who cannot afford these services otherwise. So as a part of the project, students from MDI went to various schools in Deemnagar, Parthapuri, Jacobpura, and they talked to these students. They gave them career advice. They gave them the various options that students have, you know, students of 9th, class 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, the various options that they have after class 12th. And also they took their aptitude tests, they had standardized assessments, etc. For this event, students of MDI also donated during the Joy of Giving Week, for which we were able to collect a lot of money. Now, this project was in association with Youth for Seva. So this project is basically for the visually impaired people, because not all books are available in Braille and they have problems studying. So as a part of this project, students of MDI were given books which they have to record, and we used some softwares to convert text to speech, and wherever possible, wherever the softwares were not applicable, in those areas, students themselves recorded books, and this we sent to Youth for Seva, which could be again used for the benefits of the visually impaired people. Lastly, we had a life project with Siddhant Diagnostics. So even though the life project was basically on the developing marketing strategies for Sthan Diagnostics and generating awareness in and around the Dwarka region where this service is located. However, during the course of this project, what was important and what was done was that health camps were collected. For example, in association with RWS in Dwarka, health camps were collected, and I Am Aware Club was created, because of which we were able to spread awareness among the people about how important it is to get regular health checkups done and to be proactive about your own health. We also managed the online presence for this part. Apart from all this, there were a lot of guest lectures which were conducted in MDI itself from most of the NGOs that we were associated with. One very interesting guest lecture was by Mr. George Abraham that Soma Jyoti was earlier talking about. He is the founder of SCORE Foundation. So the thing is that he himself is visually impaired. And it was a very inspiring lecture because he shared his story as to how, despite being visually impaired, he actually went through the normal school, he took admission in St. Stephen's College, and he even worked for 10 years in a marketing profile. However, there was a point in his life when he made an attempt to learn Braille. That was the point when he realized how difficult life is for actually, you know, visually impaired people. And that was the point when he decided to start this organization, and since then he's always been working for this cause. And he conducted many activities, as Swamjyoti earlier talked about. We also had a guest lecture by Mr. Aditya Gupta, who is the founder of People for Parity, where we were able to discuss very sensitive issues like those on domestic violence, female feticide, and in general about the atrocities being caused to women and what can be done to empower women. So now, the road ahead, all the ideas that we have in mind. Among all the other activities that we already have, what we plan to do is, first of all, in association with SCORE Foundation, we plan to start a campaign called Pledge Your Eyes, where all the people who are willing will find a form where they say that after their death, they can donate their eyes to others. It's a way of saying that, you know, someone else can see the world through your eyes. Then we're also planning to conduct more social experiments like the one that we had conducted earlier, in which we blindfolded the students of MDI. Similar social experiments have to see, you know, the issues that people are facing and what solutions can come out of that. We are planning to bring out more life projects. We plan to resume Disha. It's a national level beautiful competition which is organized by the National Innovation Foundation, and they give you a fund if you come up with a proper business plan to sort out social issues that are prevalent in our country. And finally, we are also in plans to develop a network of health lines across the country with the capability of taking calls in different languages and, you know, sorting out different issues accordingly as the help is needed. Also, we were thinking that we would go to the corporates to pitch for various issues, like, for example, we would pitch for computer centers. You know, there are various schools who are in need of computers, and the offices keep changing their computers on a regular interval, and I think we can leverage that opportunity for the benefit of these people. We will pitch to corporates to sponsor small things like whitewashing the school, bringing furniture, and, you know, a projector in the school, etc. And also, we are in talks with particular NGOs so that we can pitch to corporates to sponsor events like sports days for the differently abled. What else we need to do is, we have already started to integrate past members of Samaritans so that they can leverage their positions wherever they are to help our club, you know, bring out the message properly. We are also planning to bring in a communications team, because only doing is not enough. You need to spread that message properly, and you need to ensure that whatever you want to communicate gets through to the others, which is why we will be starting with a dedicated communications team for the club itself. And lastly, we would like to reevaluate our old tie-ups and see which will be beneficial for us in the future, and also try out for new ones.
Thank you. their prayer, which we take part in, we do it on a regular basis. Weekly, monthly, some activities are done weekly, some activities are done monthly, and some of the other activities are done once in 2 months. So we don't have a proper schedule for the other activities. Only the national scale activities have a proper schedule.
Also for the smaller activities, it's actually on the basis of how the NGOs require them. That, for example, if an NGO requires funds at a particular point of time, then the activity will be scheduled accordingly. So that is also kept in mind.
Do you have the proper documentation for these activities?
Yes. So we have articles on our experiences of these articles are written by various students. And time to time, we come out with these articles on our social Facebook page, and we have a documentation of most of our activities that are conducted on campus.
What is the basis of selecting NGOs? Do you follow a process, or it is like they contact you and you just form a?
Most of the cases, the NGOs contact us.
Okay.
And in some cases where students, some students can come up and say that I am associated with this particular NGO who wants to connect with Samaritans, and then we entertain them as well.
So in cases where the NGOs have not contacted us, we see as to what all activities we are already covering and what all more we can cover. For example, SCORE Foundation, we just got in touch with them last year. So we thought that, you know, this aspect we are not covering, and I think we should move into that. So we see that, and then we contact NGOs accordingly as to whether people know somebody from the NGO and depends on that.
Is there any system of verifying whether the NGO is good, not good? Do you screen the NGOs, authenticity of the NGOs?
That happens through interactions only. We don't have a particular process for that, but that happens through interactions. If you find that those NGOs are not fulfilling their major objectives that they have started out with, we do not continue our relationships with them to that extent.
I should share my personal experience that in my society, a person got badly hit and he needed about 14 units of blood. It was midnight, it was about 12:30. I called the class representative of Section D, I remember in 2009, and within 2 hours, 20 students from MDI were there in the hospital. And that is something commendable.
Students are involving various activities. Is there any system of monitoring and measuring their activities? Directly, indirectly, is there any credit system for these activities?
No, voluntary.
But how do you involve everybody?
The members of Samaritans, we are the ones who are organizing the events, we are the ones who are facilitating the events, and we have become a part of this club because we want to do such things. And otherwise, it is open for the entire batch. All those who are interested can be a part of any of our activities, and we have a lot of volunteers for all the activities. So we've never had a problem of the lack of spirit in the students because they come out themselves.
Before we launch any activity or before we design an activity, we involve all the students through our internal mail, through our internet network. They can apply, they can be a part of any event, any activity they want to be part, associated with. So that is the process.
Have you ever tried to evaluate the outcome of your efforts?
So usually all the things that we're doing, I mean, it's very difficult to measure the impact. For example, if we are going to teach children, maybe that is quantifiable as to, you know, how many classes we've taken and what impact. But other social campaigns, if we've taken as to AIDS awareness or maybe save water, it is on our level, it is difficult to measure as to what impact it has actually caused and how many people are actually falling through the campaign.
There are some evaluation systems like last year or year before last.
Without that, how will they come that they are not
in the graduation? There are some systems like in the hostel mess, they used to write down how many kgs of food wasted. And then they would give a weekly figure of that how many total wastage.
And then monthly
once
total
they start
wastage.
Writing it, then immediately they see that the wastage reduces. So some of the things are inbuilt there, But you are correct that the focus is more than evaluation on providing the service or doing
so, so you can have certain charts in your mess that last year we saved this much food by checking food wastage.
And more focus is basically you are doing rather than just looking, because you will waste time in actually evaluating. Because the purpose is basically the spirit which matters most. See, evaluation will be done against the objectives. These guys are, the simple objective is to help. So when somebody helps, it is done out of giving by yourself. Basically, it's all about having a giving mindset. So evaluation, I don't think, should be a that important parameter. Yes, for certain activities, if they evaluate, it's good.
Yes, focus is mostly on
one thing and doing.
Thank you very much.
Insights into how MBA is contributing to the society. Now I would like to invite Professor Mohammed Ahmed to please come on the stage and share and enlighten us with your experiences. Please.
My dear friend, Dr. K.N. Kapil, Sudhir Sharma ji, from MSN Meerut, S.P. Singh ji, MSN Meerut, my other dear colleague there, faculty of MDI, and my dear students. It gives me immense pleasure to be here to know about your activities. In fact, last month I came here, had some interaction with Mukul Gupta ji, and he was telling about the activities just from what you have shown. Then I made a statement, because in my profile it was told that I use little bit poetry. I told in Hindi, I was told that 95% of you know Hindi language here. Okay? I told that Achha rehna hi kaafi nahi hai, achha dikhna bhi chahiye. You are doing few of the great things here. It's good. Whenever we talk about the social work, helping others, we don't go for the show off. But at the same time, if something is good and great, it should be visible and it should be properly presented. And it should inspire others to follow the same thing. Then only it will have the multiple impact. The activity what you are doing here, it should not be for MBA Gurgaon. It should not be for Gurgaon and it should not be for Haryana. It should be for across the nation. So because of this, I told Mukul Gupta ji that let us, whatever you are doing, that you present it in a proper manner, in a different forum, the other institutions and the student community, they can follow. So this was the idea. Friends, somebody has given the introduction about me, that whatever you are hearing, that professor of management, healthcare management with 5 postgraduate degrees and all those things. Good to hear, but it is only the front end. The back end is something else. The back end is Dr. K.N. Kapil, his friend of mine. I think it was 1996. Kapil and myself, we were the batchmate at XLRI Jamshedpur, doing some program there. So, 1996. So, we have been meeting and we have been sharing whatever he does and whatever I do. Why I am involved in these activities? There is a reason. I would like to share one or two incidents then you will come to know. Somebody was telling about my educational background, but sometimes these one-page profile, they are misleading. This will not tell you. It will tell only the positives, not the negatives. Today I am little bit low because of my Ramzan fasting, because I started 3 a.m. from Hyderabad. I had various meetings. So I'll be little bit low energy-wise, but I'm confident that whatever I want to say, that will be conveyed. What happened? After my 10th class, I discontinued my studies for 3 years. Then there was a gap of 3 years. I had my schooling from a government school. I had my intermediate from government junior college. Schooling, we used to have the 10th class result less than 10%. 90% of the students, they used to fail. Similarly, at junior college level, 12th, the result used to be less than 25%. What I do every year on 31st December, I used to have the get-together of my friends who discontinued their studies 10th class or less than that, because of some reason, lack of interest, or because of financial, poor financial background. They come to my house. 31st December, usually we celebrate, so I maintain that group. 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th class. Now if I see professionally what they do, their economic activity, they have got few businesses, small businesses. Somebody is in police department, road transport department, LIC, like that. I have seen them. They work for 8 hours and 10 hours. Few of them have independent family and most of them have joint family. I'm talking about Hyderabad. They work from 9 to 6 or 9 to 8. They go home, they are with their family and parents, happy. Then I have got second group who did MBA with me from Shivaji University. I was there for 2 years. Batch of 55. Out of 55, I think hardly 8 to 10 they are in India. Remaining they are across the globe. Most of them financially settled and their job profile, income, it's okay, above average. But I found that most of them, they are not with their families and they are not able to spare the time with their relatives, particularly the parents and elders. It happens. There is a saying, zindagi mein kuch paana hai to kuch khona padega. Everything will not come freely. Because you wanted to have the qualification, placement, profile, high profile job, high package, you'll have to sacrifice something. So ultimately what I could find, that the second group, somewhere they were missing the happiness. This is one area. Because I spent my time at Ivy League, right from Harvard to the NCERT in Paris, the top management colleges in India. These management colleges, they taught a student, they trained a student, they groomed a student for different management areas, or you call it as a functional areas. How to manage your marketing function, HR function, finance function, international business, business analytics. But somewhere we missed how to manage our own life. How to manage our personal life, how to manage our family life, how to manage our social life, and how to manage our spiritual life. As a management graduate, whether you are from marketing or finance, you have been focusing always either the top line or bottom line. But somewhere we miss the lifeline. I think lifeline is also important than top line and bottom line. I'm into public speaking, traveled a lot in India, mostly the tier 2, tier 3 cities. Tomorrow I have the program in Meerut. Once I was into public speaking, a district called, you may be knowing, Jind in Haryana. Then the second activity I had in Chandigarh. From Jind, I was going by road, Jind to Chandigarh. I had one or two friends, academicians. In between, we stopped for some lunch and snacks. Or roadside dhaba, you know, Punjab, Haryana is well known. We wanted to have our lunch. You know, Haryana and Punjab, they are agriculturally rich states. Agriculture is the core activity. Roadside, we have seen one old person, maybe of 75 years of age, a farmer, doing some farming activity independently. So one of my friend, he is also professor of management, and I was there. He asked that person in Hindi language, "Kya baba, aapka koi beta nahi hai kya? Saath mein kaam karne ke liye. Aap ikele kaam kar rahe is umar mein." Then the person told in his own language, "Hai mera beta. Ek beta hai jo mere saath nahi rehta hai." क्या मतलब नहीं रहने का मतलब क्या है? तो उस बूढ़े आदमी ने कहा, थोड़ा पढ़ा गांव छोड़ा, ज्यादा पढ़ा मुल्क छोड़ा, बहुत ज्यादा पढ़ा माँ बाप छोड़ा. देन आई स्पेंड माई टाइम एज ए टीचर, मोस्ट ऑफ माई टाइम एट अलीगढ़ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मेडिकल साइंसेज. आई टीच देयर पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन कोर्स. Even I am Ahmedabad and ISB. That this qualification, placement, profile, package, it's all okay. But what is the point if our parents, elders and family members, if they do not have the happiness, if you are not able to satisfy them? I used to write on social media something like, आप बदकिस्मत हैं अगर आपके माँ बाप नहीं हैं, और आप बहुत ज्यादा बदकिस्मत हैं आपके माँ बाप है मगर आप उनका केयर नहीं करते. These are the issue. Tomorrow I have got a program, one day workshop for the management graduates like you, something different, because I believe in differentiation. The program is management lessons from Indian poetry. Their management students are working from last 2 weeks. I had given 20 poets of Urdu, 20 Hindi. Student, they are supposed to present the couplets. Minimum 2 lines, maximum 10 lines. Their meaning, and they have to give the management perspective. Just I'm quoting one or two things because it has got some relationship with today's activity what you have presented. See, we management professors, management experts, and even management gurus, because I spent some time with C.K. Pralhad, Vijay Govindarajan, Jagdish Seth, they are all management gurus. These management gurus, they write on a book of about 300 to 500 pages to explain a particular concept and theory. But management guru himself and readers, they are not sure whether the reader have understood the concept. But whereas the poet, he writes only 2 lines and everything is crystal clear. He writes only two. In a strategic management, one has to teach the course, is to use the poetry, only simple 2 lines. When you are a leader, you do not have competition. There is no number 2, number 3, number 4, up to number 10. then what do you think? There is no competition. You are the market leader. Nobody can touch me and there is no competition at all. Then Tahir Faraz, the poet, he says, Tu kisi se na harega, tujhe tera hi gurur marega. You don't require competition. You don't require opponent. You don't require enemies. We say, competition within, enemy within. Aapko marne ke liye aap khud kaafi hai. Aapko dusron ki zarurat nahi padti hai. So the point what I am telling in this contest, there is a poet, he has written something. These poets know what they see, what they observe, what they experience, they present it. And one of the poets, he has written, गरीब माँ ने अपने भूखे बच्चों को ये कहकर सुला दिया, गरीब माँ ने अपने भूखे बच्चों को ये कहकर सुला दिया, ख्वाब में आएंगे फरिश्ते रोटी लेकर, ख्वाब में आएंगे फरिश्ते रोटी लेकर. द सेम पोएट सम अदर प्लेस ही हैज रिटन, गरीब माँ बाप घर आके रोए अकेले में, गरीब माँ बाप घर आके रोए अकेले में, क्योंकि मिट्टी के खिलौने ना सस्ते थे मेले में. So this is the perspective of Indian economy, the poverty, the life, what we have in the rural areas. I think we, educated person, management graduate, the management teachers and professors, I think we have some responsibility to see, to look after, to contribute. Otherwise, some other poet says, Hamara hona bhi kis kaam ka, Hamara hona bhi kis kaam ka, Hamare na hone pe kisi ko kuch fikar na ho. What is the significance of our existence? If we are no more, nobody remembers us. I think the Robin Sharma has written a book on the same theme. Who will cry when you die? The success, the effectiveness of the individual will be identified. The how many persons will cry when you die? Once I was telling in a rural area, then he was telling, for success, so we have to die, then only you will come to know. These are the things. See, 2012, I was the national president for AIIMS, Association of Indian Management Schools. It's world's second largest association of B-School, where MBA Gurgaon and about 800 B-Schools are member, all IIMs, Xavier Group, MDI. So during my presidentship, and most of the past president, they are IIM directors, including Devi Singh, Shekhar Chaudhary, M.R. Rao, Father Abraham from XLRI, Father P.D. Thomas, all these individuals. We had a board meeting, so I was 21st president and youngest, because the average age of the president is about 62 years. I told them, the first institution, management institution, if you are talking across the globe, it is, I remember it is 1819, it is ESCP in France. In India, it is 1949, XLRI Jamshedpur. The first management institute, I'm not talking about MBA and PGDBM, they started diploma on labor relations, 1949. First MBA program started at Andhra University Commerce Department in 1957. Now we have got 4,000 management colleges. So I put a simple question to my elders, all my past presidents, 1949 to 2012, it's about 63 years. 63 years of management education of India with 4,000 management colleges as per AICT record. 63 3 years of management education, it has got a standing. 4,000 management colleges. What we have contributed at the macro level, what we have contributed to the society, what we have contributed to the nation. Individually, we would have done. At ISB, something we have done. I am Lucknow, we have done something. I am Calcutta, we have done something. XLRI, we have done something. Did we leave the impact at macro level? Okay, based on this discussion, we started AIIMS National Management Week. Out of 52 weeks, 1 week, these B schools, deans and directors, faculty and students, they will be dedicating to the nation and society. And we identified that week every year from 1st August to 7th August. 1st August to 7th August, we'll be celebrating that one. So these management colleges will be contributing. I think as a human being, you and I, everybody has got some potential, some inner thinking that I'll do some good thing. But the only problem is there may not be the opportunity. Here you have done, organized, excellent activity. I could hear, now I could see what you have done. But most of the Tier 2, Tier 3 B schools, they do not have the opportunity to do. So we have identified 1st August to 7th August as a AIIMS National Management Week. We identified more or less same activities. 7 activities we have identified. There is no compulsion that all the 7 days you must work, because you have got your own almanac schedule, academic activity, not at the cost of your own schedule. So colleges are expected to spare time, maybe 7 days, maybe 5 days, maybe 3 days, 2 days, maybe 1 day or sometime only 1 hour. I have got some poster and material that I will hand over to you. 7 activities in nutshell. Rural development is one area. Second one is education sector, government schools, government junior college, government degree college. You'll have to go there, serve there. The systems and procedures, the teachers development and faculty development. Rural development, you have to go to the slum area and you have to perform some activities, support them. Third one is healthcare, going to the hospitals, particularly government hospitals. Okay. And then you can have the tie-up with the hospital, do some activity, healthcare camp in the rural areas. Going to the orphanage and old age, including prisons. Last year, I took few of the faculty members, management teachers, to Hyderabad Central Jail. We spent half of the day. Incidentally, few of the icons and celebrities, they were there in the Hyderabad jail, including Ramlinga Raju. So sometime what happens, I'll tell you just example. I was talking about fasting. Fasting is there in almost all the religions. The system and procedure is different. In my case, just I'm giving example. I'm supposed to have the food, water, liquid before 4 a.m. and after 7 p.m. What happens in the month of summer, if you are in fasting, you are not supposed to take a glass of water. You have a glass of water, but you cannot take. 7 o'clock you can take. So when we break the fast, usually either we take that khajur, dates, or water. So I prefer water. So 7 o'clock, you will come to know the importance of water. What is drinking water actually? Otherwise we don't know. We are talking about conserve water, all those things. What is water, you will come to know. My nephew, he has done PGDPM from Vellinkar, Mumbai. posted to Infosys. Now he is in London. This fasting time, it is sunset and sunrise. Sunrise and sunset. He called me, Mama, you should come to London to have fasting. Because here timing is 4 a.m. early morning. Before that we should have the food, and after 7 p.m. London, it is 2:30 a.m. You should have the food before that, 2:30 a.m. You can break the fast at 9:30 p.m. 20 hours. Why I am quoting this example? You will come to know the value of glass of water. You will come to know the value of thirst. जो भूख होती है ना हमें समझ में आती है जब. And this is the philosophy of fasting. Most of the religion. I heard in the giants, this is the most difficult task among the giants. It's not one religion. So these are the things. So I am concluding with few points. There are so many things we can talk. This I am handing over. Whatever you have done, I think that you will have to channelize, document. Make it in a presentable form. I have got poster and few guidelines. What you are supposed to do. Whatever activities previously you have done, it's okay. It's only the background scenario. 7 days, not necessary 7 days, 1 or 2 days you can take under your banner, and then prepare a document, maximum 20 pages, digital form, soft copy, send it to AIIMS convention, which will be every year in the month of August. This year, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, it is in Pune. The deans and directors, faculty and students from about 200 B schools will be gathering there. And we have the national awards, various awards. One of the award is there for the National Management Week for the social service. We call it as ISR, Institutional Social Responsibility, what you have. And we identify 3 best institutions. For other awards, no, usually what we do, first, second, third, gold medal, silver medal, bronze. But here we have done, there's no ranking. 3 best institutions, all 3 will get gold medal. Incidentally, Sharmaji and SP Singhji, they are from MSM Meerut, Master School of Management Meerut, and last year they got the gold medal for that one. And PSG Coimbatore, and one more institution from Vizag. Other institution may not be knowing because of that, because we had proposals we got about, say 25 proposals we got. So we call about 10 proposals. The individuals, they come from the respective college, they make the PowerPoint presentation the way you present it. So last year competition, MSM and 2 more institutions, they got it. Whatever you have done, more or less same thing they have done. But you will have to perform these activities in that particular week or a day or two. So that I am giving. Now, most of the institutions, they started this CSR activity, ISR activity as extracurricular or supporting activity. But I would like to clarify one thing, because I have got my own limited experience exposure of about 24 years. In early 2000, the best B school across the globe, we call it as an Ivy League, and here the top 10, top 50 in India. They had the problem after placing the students. After placing the student, they are not able to sustain in their function, whether it is marketing or HR or financing. And few management professors and management groups, they had some observation. They found the best B schools in India and abroad focusing on all the skills, almost all, right from conventionally, you know, you used to call communication skills, interpersonal skills, managerial skills, now you talk about business analytics, all those things. But they have found the students from the best B school, they are lacking something like social skills. Because India is not Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, Hyderabad and Chennai. India, 647 districts, okay, and about 65% of India, 70% of India, it is in rural area. So these management graduate with their skills, they are not able to cope up and sustain. So now, after 2000, the best B school, whether it is in India or Ivy League, they thought, let us teach groom student not only for your managerial, interpersonal, soft skills, it is also social skills. And ultimately, I conclude, in my public speaking, public speaking means I address doctors, engineers and others, other professionals. In our life, professional life, we should focus on three activities, or we should divide our life into three phases. May not be mathematically one third, but we should divide our life into three phases. The first phase, we should focus on learning. Whatever profession, whatever domain you have got, focus more on learning, relearning, you call it unlearning also. The second phase, it is earning. This is also very important. We have some economic activity, whether you are in service or business or profession, earning is also important. Third one, I call it as returning. You have to return also. MBI Gurgaon, one of the best B school in India. It's in top 5, top 10. You are sitting there as a student. I am standing here as a teacher. I have got my colleagues there. Can I ask you, how you got into the MBI? It's not an easy entry, no? You'll have to prepare yourself. There was a competition. In that competition, you got selected. So the point what I'm telling, today if you are here as an MBI student, and your teachers are here, I'm here, of course it is your efforts and hard work. But I say, there was a great contribution from the different individuals and parties. Your parents, your relatives, your teachers, your friends, individuals from the society. I also include your neighbors. Everybody contributed. Because of that contribution, I think you are there and I am here, we could achieve something. So, it is learning, it is earning, it is returning. As a teacher of accounting and finance, I strongly believe that principle of double entry bookkeeping system. Principle says, every debit has a corresponding credit. I also say, every credit has corresponding debit. But in principle of double entry bookkeeping system, what you debit, the same amount you credit. But I say, when we talk about the social activity, helping others, whatever others have debited, your credit should be more than debit. Somebody has credited you by 1 rupee, then the debit should be minimum 100 rupees, something like that. I think if this is the feeling, if this emotion if you have, I think we can serve the society, we can serve the community and serve the mankind. There is a saying in Urdu, a little bit technical, but I would like to say, Khidmat-e-Khalq sabse badi ibadat hai. Khalq, service to the mankind is the greatest prayer. Service to the mankind is the greatest prayer. I think this we should remember. And 100 years ago, the great poet of India, Iqbal, he has written something for future India. He has written, Na samjhoge to mit jaoge, ae Hindustan walo, tumhari daastan tak na hogi daastanon mein. Anticipate the change. Follow the change. Adopt the change. Otherwise, your name will not be there in the history. All the best. Thank you. These are the few posters. Who are the volunteers who are looking after Samaritans? See, this is the poster every year we issue, 1st to 7th August. The caption is here, come together, work together and achieve together. These are the things and these are the 7 activities we have. I think this I will give to you. Then whatever is feasible and possible, we should do it. And I am expecting that I think 10th August is the last date for submission of proposal entry from your side. Any 2 students, they can come to that Pune. Usually the shortlisted candidates, about 10 institutes will be inviting them and will give the to and fro and their accommodation, will make the arrangement there. I think these are the few posters I would like to give it to you. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. You very rightly pointed out that we are so busy running after so many things in life that we forget the basic, most important thing in the life, that is our lifeline. Which we should also understand, our parents are also getting old and we should contribute more towards them. As they have, the basic reason why we are here is because of them. I, on behalf of all the student fraternity, would like to offer my sincere thanks for coming here out of your busy, taking time out of your busy schedule and enlightening us with all the insights. I am very sure that this session has have had very profound effect on all the students and they have gained a lot and will be able to contribute more towards the society and towards their personal life. They will be able to make better choices when it comes to following a dream, like you mentioned, following a dream or giving more time to your parents. Now I would request Team Samarpak Soumya to present a moment or two. Soumya.